I can throw a tube jig there. It's 9, 10, 11 feet of water. Maybe pop one on a tube. When there's two, three, four together, they'll race at it. Let's try it. Pick, I'll have this right here. My trusty topwater back and forth. My little 3.5-inch tube jig. Maybe they'll think it's a perch and just whack, slam it. Let it sink down in a small snap. And it's so important to be near these weeds. So important. I see the rock, and these fish are just coming in and out, in and out. The ones I see out there, yeah, I can pick up the drop shot. I could probably catch them. But I think those are the ones that are chilling out. They've eaten already. They're going to eat, but they're just chilling out. I want the ones that are aggressively feeding. And every once in a while, I come into these weeds. I have my track on, the chart. I got the sonar, traditional. I can see the weed. Sometimes I see the tops, and sometimes all I see on the sonar is just the tips of the weed, knowing that there's weed down there. This gives me that extra confidence to fish, knowing that these smallmouth are near the weed and rock, just like this here. Look at it. Weed, 6.7. It's all weed there, different things. And here's my track. So I go out wider, see where I've been, and make waypoints. That's 120 feet, 120 meters out. So when I'm real tight, I bring it in and see where I've been. So a combination of traditional sonar with a chart are helping me catch these smallmouth on Island Lake Camp. Oh, the surface right there. Yep. Wow, eh? Just finished saying, huh? Just finished saying. Got near those weeds. And I felt that familiar. Boop. Oh, yeah. Isn't that nice? Oh, yeah. Just a chunky fish. Beautiful Ontario smallmouth. You can't beat that, man. Throw in the top waters, different baits, kiss and release, okay? Ready? Go on. Wow. Just snapping it. Yep. See, I got my hand, when I throw that tube jig, I know that it's like throwing a bucktail. I do it enough times, I know where the fish are. It's all about timing, fish moving in to feed and stuff. And I just finished saying, I need one to be about 2 feet below the surface. I saw the weeds coming off that point, threw in, went down about that far, boom, right away.
Island Lake Camp, where reality meets paradise. As you leave Highway 64 and travel 3.5 miles to the end of the road, you'll begin a truly northern experience. When you arrive at Island Lake Camp, you will find 8 well-appointed pine-decorated cottages encircling a quiet bay on Thistle Lake. Secluded sandy beaches, waterfalls, and their own hidden bay will beckon you. Relax at the water's edge and view the glorious lake views from your screened-in porch. In the evenings, gather around the wood stove, enjoy a game of cards, watch TV, or just swap stories with other guests. Fishing at Island Lake Camp is excellent for walleye, smallmouth bass, and trophy-sized northern pike. As the only outfitter on the lake and no other boat access to this lake, this makes for great fishing for walleyes in the spring and fall near the two rivers flowing into the lake. All the lodge boats are equipped with 4-stroke electric start motors, fish finders, padded seats, and are fully serviced every day. Contact Gord Mitchell at Island Lake Camp to book your Northern Ontario adventure at this clean, comfortable, and truly wonderful outfitter located in Field, Ontario.
Something magical for me, getting up early, the anticipation, the butterflies of just going fishing. And that's what I did on this trip to Island Lake Camp. Just went fishing, caught some fish, saw a bunch more, but just had a fantastic adventure once again in Northern Ontario.
All right, we go to this reef that he's got that runs right across the lake from point to point. And the point that we're on, big boulders going out about 200 yards. It just tapers slow, like you talk about a walleye and smallmouth magnet. But the edges just taper down.
The old school, doing the drift, bouncing the bottom. You got him?
Yeah.
That passed. How's he feel?
He feels like a pickerel.
Let me know. I'll get this out of the way.
Yeah, here he comes.
Good walleye?
Yeah, yeah,
it's
pickerel.
Oh, nice, nice, nice. See where we are. Oh, boy. Hey. Whoop. Oh. You see all the net again? Oh. See? There you go.
There you go.
Just like you said, old school drift, eh?
Yeah.
On the edge of the reef. That's a nice chunk. He's in the slot for sure.
Nice pickerel,
yeah. Yeah, he's probably 18. Nice, healthy walleye.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. It's a bit of blue on him.
I see that, too.
Yeah. And on the tail.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Oh. See ya, buddy. Close. Didn't know what hit him.
Yeah.
Well, let's finish this trip. Maybe finish for the day. What do you think?
Yeah, I'm up for it.
Okay.
The day's almost done. Let's get up the top end of that and do one or two more drifts. What happens? Brad gets a good 17. While I put my rod down, I see it go dunk, and then wah, my rod is ready to go over the side of the boat. I lift up, set hook, and I'm like, dudes, this is a big fish.
Oh, you got one?
Yeah, I got a good one, too.
Oh, here.
Oh, yeah, that's a big one, dude.
Oh, nice.
Let's see.
That's a big one here. Right?
Oh, yeah, that's a big one. Oh, boy. That's a good one.
Might have to net them both at the same time.
Uh-oh. Look at him coming down playing possum. Uh-oh. Might need the net.
A nice fish. I got to leave him in the net. He's all hooked
okay.
up.
Oh, boy.
Oh, he's big.
Yeah.
He's a nice fish, man.
Yeah. Ready? There you go.
Nice.
There's an ending to your show. Hey, dude. Hey, Lake Harridge. See the phone number on the screen right now? You best call it, boys and girls, because the walleyes are big and there's plentiful. Come here, big girl. You made my day at Harridge Lodge. Oh, see ya.
There he goes.
You want big walleyes? Think about this place right here. You know, Brad and his wife really have everything you want. Fantastic accommodations, great location, beach, clean places. But what's really important to you? Really? Catching big, beautiful walleyes, man. But we got to do what we did here today. Catch them, release them. We got some smaller ones to eat, have the pike and stuff. But just, man, respect this kind of fishery, because this will be here for years if you do that. You come here, you can have fun like I had. And it's just, it's someplace you got to consider. Call the number on the screen, look at the email, let them know that you want to come over here to Temagami and catch some beautiful walleyes.
Here at Lake Harridge Lodge, we have 10 cabins. We can accommodate about 40 to 45 people. We have a beautiful beach, great for families, lots of area to swim and play around. We have a bunch of beach toys as well. So like I said, it's very family friendly. Beautiful main lodge as well with a pool table, satellite TV, just to escape those rainy days, right? At Lake Harridge Lodge, we also offer remote lake fishing packages. And we take you through a series of remote lakes, including four series of lakes, Harridge onto three other lakes. And the fishing throughout the entire lake system is just fantastic. Our cabins range from bachelor style to a 9-person cabin, and they range from about four to six people each. They're fully equipped with fridge, stove, microwave, coffee machine, toaster, everything you'd need to get away. We pride ourselves in cleanliness. That is definitely top priority to us. At Lake Harridge Lodge, we promote catch and release, but if you did want to have a little shore lunch, it's no problem to keep small walleye under the slot, or bass and pike as well. They're great fish to eat, and it's such a healthy system around here. And we also have a boat launch as well, so people can bring their own boats. We have a great docking system, as you can see behind us. Recently, a guest caught a 31-inch walleye. Beautiful, beautiful fish. and it was just great. He was very happy about it, and it made his trip. We welcome all our guests from Canada and the United States. We have a great place. You will definitely enjoy your time here, and we welcome you with open arms. Come visit us at Lake Carriage Lodge and Resort in Temagami, Ontario.
I'm going to show you something about using small baits for good-sized bass. You say, okay, he's didn't finesse for him before, you know, on split shot rigs and things like that. But I'm going to rig it on one of the most popular little setups, jig heads that are the rave right now. A little Ned rig, Ned jig, Ned head, mushroom head, whatever you want to call it. But I'm going to fish it on that little jig head right there. This is 1/8 ounce. I'm going to fish anywhere between 2 feet to about 6-7 feet, okay? I want it to go through the whole water column. Even when I'm lifting it up as well too, I have a chance that maybe fish flare at it when they see that little tail of the finesse worm just twisting and turning, okay? I got two rods rigged up. I got one with a little black and chartreuse kicking tail, okay? Same thing, 1/8 ounce. As for line, 8-pound Gamma Touch fluorocarbon, little Daiwa, and this is a weapon. Not a fishing rod, this is a weapon of bass destruction. 7-foot medium power Legend X by St. Croix. Probably one of the finest rods ever built in the fishing industry. Bold statement, pick one up, try it, and you'll see what I mean. Small little finesse worms on the Ned rig, fished along the first edges and breaks. We'll put some smallmouth in the boat for me, and it will for you too. Let's go catch some fish.
It's a good one. Oh yeah, that's a nice fish right there, boy. Oh yeah, nice, nice fish. Actually, let's turn around this way. It's nice when I have to consider using the net. You know they're better bass, huh? Come here. Jumped in the net. Ooh, that's getting chunkier. That's getting chunkier. Look where he's got it. Look at that. Yeah, that's a nice fish anywhere, man. I don't care where you fish for smallmouth. Look at that. That's a gorgeous bass. Real nice, man. Isn't that nice? Nice and fat. Hey, we'll take some pictures of you and let you go. You talk about small adjustments making big differences, okay? I was fishing up tight, you know, 3 feet, thinking there's gonna be roaming fish, because I saw some. You know, I got the polarization in my glasses, and I got the green lens so I can see anything. It's shadows. I'm catching the ones that are in 5-6 feet on the taper, just moving, eating crawdaddies, eating perch. I'm catching fish and I see them regurgitating those things. So look sometimes, look where you're fishing. See the edges and stuff? It's the first breaks, 5 feet, 6 feet, where you can't see the bottom. Oh boy, that one feels a bit better, I'd say. Off that edge, huh? Oh boy, little Ned rig. Whoa, look at him go. He's gonna jump, ready? Look at him, wow, came out like a steelhead. Sitting out in the 5.5, 6 feet. How can you not like smallmouth bass, boy? How can you not like that? Small mouth, big attitude. Look where that hook is too. Okay, officially I did touch the leader, okay? I did touch it. Oh, there he is. Again, see what I talked about those hooks? Pass the lip, pop out. And that right there concludes my afternoon of bass fishing, right there. A beautiful, thick, crayfish eating creature of Northern Ontario, right there. Let you go, okay? Beautiful specimen, ready?
The Outpost Lodge is not primarily a fishing camp. It is a vacation resort in the true sense of the word. It is in a magnificent location and central to so many great fishing lakes in the Mississauga River Valley that appeals to anglers and their families since the early 1930s with this fully restored resort, providing memorable family vacations in the Cambrian Shield wilderness of Algoma Country.
Kasagami Wilderness Lodge. Everyone knows it. You've seen it on TV,
You read magazines about it. You've seen it on social media. Something about this place is magical. It's always about those big, giant, gator-like pike. But this boy is going there for those walleyes. I've seen the brochures. I've talked to Charlie at the trade shows. He says, Carl, seriously, 100 walleye days. And you know, I'm just like anybody else. You know, I have a little bit of skepticism when somebody says 100 walleyes. That's a lot of walleyes. I'm not going to fish from 5 a.m. to 10 p.m. But no, it is true. This place is magical when it comes to walleye. All right, we do the fly-in. We're here at Kasagami, and it's great. Just a perfect weather. You know, we couldn't ask for anything more perfect. Nice place. It's got the accommodations that everybody raves about, the meals that are mouth-watering, but it's the walleyes that I've come for. So we get here, we set up, they hook us up with Pat, one of the guides, and they have like dock hands. They have a real well-oiled machine here. And Charlie at the top of the totem pole there, he just, you know, helps everybody make this place run as smooth gets. Like they're there, they get your luggage, they put it in your cabin, in your place you're staying, you know, you have breakfast or lunch ready, depends what time you come in on the planes. And then you decide to hook up with Pat. We go out to one of the first spots, and lo and behold, sunny, bright, we're only about 5 feet of water, and I start pounding on the walleye.
At that time. Oh man, oh man, is there a lot of walleyes here? Is there a lot of walleyes here? Look at this. Just beautiful walleye, man. Wow, right in the schnoz. Hey, walleye's like, come on, just get me, take me out. Wow, wow, wow. Gorgeous, gorgeous, eh? Nom, nom. Oh, I might keep one for lunch. One for lunch. Let's see if I can get another one right away. Ethan must put my... Not that time. Just so many gorgeous fish. Sure, hey, you're doing an awesome job, man. Putting me on them, unhooking them. So many 16s and a half, 17. Yeah, they're gorgeous fish. You would not starve in Kasagami, would you? And what's the deal? A couple of walleyes around 18 and under, right, for lunch? That's a deal? Yeah, okay.
How simple is simple? Think about walleyes. There's one criteria here that you have to remember. It's catch and release. That sustains this fishery. That this lodge was really innovative years ago with introducing the catch and release program. A little bit of blowback, you know, from people that maybe came to areas that filled up the coolers and brought fish home, but that's not the days anymore. You want to come to areas that have potential 100 walleye days. And because Kasagami did that years ago, this is the kind of fishery they have now. And it's such an easy way to fish. Curly-tailed grub in bright yellow with chartreuse head will get it done.
Yeah, on top. And that's walleye, it's pretty good. Might be northern. Oh, that's good walleye. Oh boy. Look where he is, right to the nose too, huh? Wow. Yeah, I can get a little splish splash. Maybe splash of the air. Look how he's got that, right? He couldn't get any tighter. Watch, I won't even touch him. Wow, what a fishery.
Let's sink. Oh boy, dude, what are you? Oh, that's a big walleye, dude. Nice walleye. Yeah, look at it. Where is that? Oh, it is too. Look at it. Oh, just a nice one. Look at that. Oh, that's just a beautiful fish, isn't it? Yeah, yeah. Okay. Wow. Look at that, man. Look at that fish. Now that's Kasagami walleyes. Look at that, man. That's 18 for sure, isn't it?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
World-class pike, double world-class walleyes. Wow, man.
Fish, Carl.
Yeah, man.
Look at the color, it's beautiful.
Yeah, and right here, I changed up, I got a little jig head. See the flat back there? So it sort of rides over the rocks and stuff. And the 2.75 rate swimmer, and just a little icon casting. But that is the deal at Kasagami. You cast, you let it sink. Watch your line, because a lot of times it's just going to jump 2 feet. When you're right in that zone where they are, which is about 7.5 feet over 8, and then they come up this slope on this break, you meet right here on these rocks. Just phenomenal fishing. Right there, another good one too. Oh, that's good, this one, dude. Even bigger than the last one.
Is it?
Yeah, it's bigger than the last one. Look at this one. That is nice walleye right there. Look at that. Isn't that gorgeous?
Oh,
look how thick they are. Big heads on them.
Big ones, yeah,
man.
Nice.
Kasagami.
Let this guy swim.
This place truly is a bucket list for anybody who loves to fish. Think about Kasagami Wilderness Lodge, because it is the place that you'll come once and you'll never forget it.